In this video, I'm going to explain anatomy of gluteus medius. I will explain its origin, insertion, and function. You see, origin of gluteus medius is very broad. Actually, this red tape represents anterior fiber. This beige tape represents middle fiber. And blue one is posterior fiber. It's very broad muscle. It attaches on very close to iliac crest and the lateral side of pelvis. I will explain why I make different colors. Okay? And insertion is here, lateral side of the femur. This point is called greater trochanter. Greater trochanter. So that's it. Origin, external surface of ilium, pelvis, and insertion is greater trochanter. Then, basically, main function of gluteus medius is abduction of the hip joint. Abduction is when you open up hip joint, you raise leg the laterally. This is abduction. This muscle does abduction. Then why do I make different colors? Because depends on the fiber, it has different functions. I will explain from anterior fiber. You see, anterior fiber is red tape. If this red tape pulls the femur this way, what would it do? It does, of course, abduction, but this can do other functions. What if this muscle pulls this way? It will do flexion of hip joint. Flexion. Or if this pulls this way again, it can do internal rotation. I will say it again. If this red tape pulls this way, it can do flexion and internal rotation. This is hip movement. However, since this muscle can pull this way, right, you know, like this way, it can pull pelvis this way, you know, this way. This movement is anterior tilt of pelvis. Why? Because this can pull the pelvis this way, right? That's why it can do this kind of movement. This is anterior tilt of pelvis. So, review. Anterior fiber can do, of course, abduction, flexion, internal rotation of hip joint, and if anterior fiber pulls this way, it can do anterior tilt of pelvis. This is very, very important. Middle part doesn't do much flexion extension, internal rotation, or pelvic movement. It is very strong abductor. I don't think this middle fiber is involved for much flexion extension and rotational movement. That's it, middle fiber, that's it. So this blue one is posterior fiber. Actually, function of posterior fiber is opposite from anterior fiber. So what this posterior fiber does, it will pull femur this way. This is extension. Extension of hip joint and external rotation of hip joint. That was different from anterior fiber, right? Anterior fiber was flexion and internal rotation. Posterior fiber, extension and external rotation. Then posterior fiber can pull pelvis this way as well, you know, because of the direction of fiber. What can this do for pelvis? If this muscle pulls this way, it can do this movement. This is posterior tilt of pelvis. Anterior fiber was anterior tilt. Posterior fiber is posterior tilt. You know, speaking of pelvic movement, hamstrings or rectus femoris or other muscles are very famous for this pelvic movement. However, if you look at a gluteus medius carefully, this can also do posterior tilt or anterior tilt. I'd like to say one more thing. Deep to gluteus medius, there's muscle called gluteus minimus. Gluteus minimus is slightly smaller than gluteus medius, like this. Actually, gluteus minimus is very similar to gluteus medius. It's small muscle, but you can divide anterior part, middle part, and posterior part. It's not as strong as gluteus medius. However, it has similar function. So, gluteus minimus can do flexion, internal rotation, pelvic movement, yadi yadi yadi, same as gluteus medius. So, I say gluteus medius and gluteus minimus. These guys are very important for hip movement and pelvic movement. I cannot emphasize enough, these guys are so important for both hip joint and pelvis. So this is today's video. If you liked it, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.